Okay, in this segment I will talk about the center of pressure for submerged plates. So far, what we have covered is we find anywhere in the fluid field what is the pressure. So we were able to answer that question. And then we went ahead and converted that pressure information to a distributed force information that I need. So far, we have accomplished those two. Now the next thing is, where is this force acting? Okay, so think about your static forces. This is important concept. And I have some good news and I have some bad news about the center of pressure. The good news is that there's nothing new here. Everything is based on your statics knowledge. And you will be finding out that I will be talking about second moment of area, the moment of inertia. So those are things that come straight from the statics. So that's the good part. Let me tell you the bad news about it. There's nothing new here. Everything is based on statics. If your statics is not as good as you hope it to be, we may have a problem, okay? So you may need to visit your statics class notes. Actually, it's gonna take a while for me to draw it. I'll be right back. Okay, here it is. So I drew this for you to save some time. So what I'm looking over here is this. I have a plate, and I highlighted with a fairly thick font, okay? And this is the free surface, so, and there is an angle of theta that it makes with respect to the horizontal direction. Think that I'm following the Munson-Young Okishi over here, and what they did was they recommended that the direction of y is this. Okay, that's quite different than what we have covered so far. I'd like you to take note. Okay, and into the page is x. So that part is the same as what we have covered before. The question here is there will be pressure force, and actually let me go ahead and draw that for you. And if you think about it, the pressure increases linearly as I go down into the surface, right? So I will have something like this over here, okay? And if I plot this, it's going to be like a distributed force. As you know, the pressure is perpendicular to the surface. And this Fr, actually, let's go ahead and draw this in another color. So this combined force Fr, we call this Fp, the pressure force in my modules, right? So now I'm interested in, hey, what is this distance, okay, all the way from here to here? And people refer to this as YR, so I will be consistent with the book's nomenclature. So again, if you think about this, this is a very typical statics problem from your statics course. So there's nothing new in here. I'm not going to be driving it for you, okay? But I will be writing the final equation and I will discuss that, okay? So here's what it says. This yr will be equal to yc, hang on a second, I'll talk about it, ixc divided by yc times a, okay? And let's talk about this ixc right over here. This is the second moment of area, and this is also fairly known to the students as well as moment of inertia. Again, a concept directly coming from the statics courses. And if I continue the same type of analysis, I will get myself an XR as well. And you will see it looks symmetric. XC plus IXYC divided by YC times A. Okay, before I go further, let me talk a little bit about what I'm talking about here. The YR is this orange color, and where this one force, the combined force, acts on. It says that it's related to the YC. Okay, YC, C stands for centroid of the area. Typically, what happens is this will be, let's draw it over here, so like this, this will be YC. Okay, this is centroid of it. So let's say that this is rectangle, a fairly common geometry over here. So from here to here, into the pages, let's say some distance, and this is a rectangular cross section over here. Then YC will be right at the center of it, okay, just the middle of this. This distance will be equal to this distance. Note what's happening over here. I have an additional distance. Look at it. It says YR, which is this whole distance, is equal to YC, which is this font, plus, so this is this distance will be this green font over here. And if you think about it, so this will be IXC divided YC times area, okay? And IXC is tabulated in any book that you may cover, and I will write a common geometries that we encounter in fluid mechanics to you, so you will be aware of that. Okay, so this is the second moment of area. This is why C is already given in the figure. A is the area of this plate, so it's not that fancy. Okay, and if I do the same thing for IXYC, if I see the same thing for X direction, remember X is going into the page over here, I can obtain where is the center of the pressure for this particular geometry as well. So one thing I would like to highlight over here is, as you note, YR is larger than YC, right? Because I'm adding something additional to it from here, right? I always have this one additional to it, okay? Something to note. But typically, I have some good news. This XR in many of the geometries that we deal with will be equal to XC. So I don't have to actually worry about this. And I'll write it for you so you know what I'm talking about. And here's what it says. If the area that I'm dealing with over here, which is submerged under the some kind of a fluid, is symmetric. Wait a second, I'll explain symmetric with respect to what? So I have to be specific. With respect to X or, I want to underline this, or Y, centroidal axes, what will happen is my IXYC will be equal to zero. So obviously from here, I will get myself XR is equal to XC. So that's quite possible, okay? And that's quite common as well. Actually now, let me go ahead and talk a common shapes that I encounter, okay? So the first one that I'm gonna start with is gonna be a rectangle, okay? And I gave that example when I was talking about the fundamentals. So this is given as B, this is given as A. The axis is like this. So this is this X direction, and this is the Y direction. Okay, so this needs some explanation. Let me go up here. This is the Y direction, right? In this direction, Y, into the page, into the screen, is the X direction. That's what I'm talking about, okay? In this geometry, the things that I need is the area. Well, we kind of know that. IXC, 1 over 12 BA cube. I'm sure you're very familiar with this from your statics courses, okay? But one thing that we discussed, and I will give an example right over here, that saying, hey, if the area is symmetric with respect to X or Y centroidal axis, then this will be zero. So let's take a look at it. Is this symmetric with respect to this? Look at the top half and the bottom half. Is this symmetric? Yep. Then my IXYC will be zero. So that's a good thing. And therefore, I will get my XR is equal to XC, the centroid of a rectangle, okay? The second common shape, you will imagine this as well, is the circle, okay? So let's draw this like that. So this is the X, this is the Y, and radius, you can imagine this will be the radius, okay? Area will be pi r square, we know that part. And IXC will be equal to pi r to the 4 divided 4. I'm sure you're familiar with this as well. And okay, let's take a look at it. Is this symmetric up and down, the bottom off and top off? Yep. My IXYC will be 0, so XR will be the centroid of the circle, which is right at this point, right? So this will be good. And there will be semicircle. So basically, I have something like this, okay? And I still have the same directions, that is X, this is Y over here. So you kind of know the area already. Area will be half of a full circle, right? IXC will be 0.11 approximately, R to the power of 4. Okay, so you can see it's quite different than here to here, right? And let's take a look at the symmetry. Do I have symmetry over here in the top half and bottom half? No. Okay, I better have it in the y direction then. So if I have it, do I have a symmetry right and left? Oh yeah, that's good. So what I will get is my IXYC will be equal to 0, therefore XR will be equal to XC, just like the previous case. And I want to show one additional geometry. And this additional geometry is actually not that common, but I'll make a point. I want to show something that has IXYC non-zero, okay? for your understanding purposes. So let's do this. Let's save something like this. Let's say something like that. And this is A. This is D. And this distance is a B. Okay? And I define this is the centroid, so it will be X, it will be Y. Okay. So the area part, we kind of know. A, B by 2, right? Height times base divided by 2. IXC is also manageable. So that is BA cube divided by 36. It's symmetric rectangle, right? Except the number over here. Okay. And let's look at the symmetry. This is what I wanted to make point about. So if I look at the symmetry with respect to the y-axis, I sure don't have a symmetry here and here. Okay. Let's look at the x-axis. And you can see now that I don't have the top up and bottom up symmetric. It's asymmetric. So now my IXYC will be non-zero. Now that's not good news because this is a detailed mathematics. BA squared divided by 72B minus 2D. Okay. So this kind of finishes my approach to finding center of pressure. Now I will start solving questions to illustrate how it's done for a few real-life applications.